great day. Thank you for tuning in to Moments of Inspiration presented by Shiloh Baptist Church of Baltimore County. This segment is initiated by Bishop Heber M. Brown II, the presiding prelate of the Praise Covenant Interdenominational Fellowship and pastor of Shiloh Baptist Church of Baltimore County. This moment of inspiration will be available for the entire month. We welcome you to click on this link throughout the month whenever you need to be energized in your faith, seek direction and purpose from the Word of God, and want empowerment to embrace the task that lies ahead. May this word and prayer bless and renew you upon each viewing. Our scripture references for today are in the Message version, and they come from Colossians chapter 3, verses 1 through 2, and it reads, "So if you're serious about living this new resurrection life with Christ, act like it. Pursue the things over which Christ presides. Don't shuffle along, eyes to the ground, absorbed with the things right in front of you. Look up and be alert to what is going on around Christ. That's where the action is. See things from His perspective." Our second scripture reference comes from Luke chapter 21, verses 16 through 19, and it reads, "You'll even be turned in by parents, brothers, relatives, and friends. Some of you will be killed. There's no telling who will hate you because of me. Even so, every detail of your body and soul, even the hairs of your head, is in my care. Nothing of you will be lost. Staying with it, that's what is required. Stay with it to the end. You won't be sorry. You'll be saved." The title for this segment is called Stand in Spite Of. God's word is filled with many blessings and promises to those who stand for Him. This lets us know that the battles we face are not in vain, and the struggle to hold fast to our faith in the midst of adversity is not pointless, because we know honor and blessings are held for those who stand for God. With all the turmoil going on around us, whether it be in close proximity or not, it may seem as though Christians are failing at this thing called life. Christian values are being mocked, and those who are holding on to those values are being ridiculed. When we look at the world through our natural and carnal eyes, it is easy to have feelings of fear, despair, and hopelessness, and ultimately question God and His plans for our lives. It is in these moments that we need to change our perspective and remember the promises of God. We all know the end is victory, and not just God's victory, but His followers as well. We win in the end. The Bible is clear about this. Yet when we experience dark days, we need direction. We stop and question, how do we as followers press toward victory? How do we remain steadfast in our faith? How do we react to the injustices we see in the world? This is when we can turn to God's word, where He tells us to stand. Standing is not always easy. As scripture tells us, you will be betrayed, hated, and even distressed. Jesus tells His disciples in Luke chapter 21 that it will come on all those who live on the face of the whole earth, but be always on the watch and pray that you may be able to escape all that is about to happen, and that you may be able to stand before the Son of Man. God never promised a life of no trouble, but He did provide blessings of protection, guidance, and victory. God isolates you so you can get yourself together. It may seem like you lost friendships and relationships, but a better you is worth more. For without the struggle, how can we appreciate the blessing? Today, I charge you to change your perspective and look up and be alert to what is going on around Christ, for that is where the action is. See things from His perspective. Stand on the promises of God. He is all-knowing, all-powerful, and everything we need and more. Because of His preeminent greatness, we can traverse through life with assurance and boldness because we have the ultimate backup. So how do we as followers press toward victory? How do we remain steadfast in our faith? How do we react to the injustices in the world we see? We stand in spite of. Let us pray. God, we thank You for this moment of inspiration. God, we thank You for this day. God, we thank you for the lives that you have given us, the breath in our bodies, and the activity of our limbs. God, we ask that you give us the holy boldness that we can stand in spite of the troubles that we face. God, we ask that you give us the holy boldness that we can confront those injustices around us. God, we ask that you give us the holy boldness that we can apply your word to our lives and hold others and ourselves accountable to what you have said for us. God, we know that there will not be a day without trouble, God. But God, we thank you for the victory in advance. God, we thank you for the promises of you and that they are yea and amen. God, we thank you for who we will touch and who we will hold up. And God, we thank you for those who will hold us up. God, thank you in spite of us. Thank you. And even because of us. Thank you because of Jesus, God. We thank you for your son and that he has given us the way of life, that he has given us a path that we can follow. God, we thank you for his teachings and we thank you for his leadership and we thank you for his love and sacrifice. God, we thank you for you and your sacrifice and your love towards us, that you would send us such a son that we could follow. God, we thank you for the Holy Spirit, who is our greatest leader and teacher. And God, we thank you that the Holy Spirit will lead us and guide us and comfort us as you have set forth. God, thank you in advance for the victory. For we know that within you all things are possible and that you never fail. God, we love you on today and we bless you because you are powerful, because you are mighty, and because you are holy. God, we love you on today. And we ask that you go with us throughout this day and give us the faith, the boldness, and the love of you so that others may see you in us. Amen. Dear friend, if you are viewing this segment and are not sure of your salvation, we'd like to offer Christ to you. You don't have to join our church, but we do ask that you read the following scriptures: Romans chapter 5, verse 8, John chapter 1, verse 12, Romans chapter 10, verse 9, and John chapter 5, verse 24. Know that God loves you, died for your sins, and wants to be your Savior. For additional information, please feel free to call our church office. May God and His peace be with you. Thank you for viewing.